Support comes from the Missouri Forest Products Association, providing more than 41,000 jobs in the production of wood pallets, railroad ties, white oak barrels, hardwood floors, and more. Details at choosewood.com.
We hope you enjoy listening to this podcast of St. Louis on the Air, brought to you by University College at Washington University. With undergraduate and graduate programs, part-time, evening, and online. University College at Washington University, offering world-class education within reach.
Welcome to St. Louis on the Air. I'm Don Marsh. Our We Live Here podcast team of Camille Stanley and Tim Lloyd has a follow-up to a story they've been following in their ongoing season series of episodes on St. Louis area housing issues. Joining me in studio is reporter and producer Tim Lloyd. Well, Tim, our friend Latasha Johnson is back on your podcast, your latest podcast. Bring us up to speed on that story before we continue.
Sure. Well, let me just kind of take a step back and give sort of the you know, as quickly
background.
As I can,
that,
a little background. For. Yeah. So Latasha Johnson is a woman who was renting a place in Northwest St. Louis County, and the roof literally to her apartment above her bathroom fell in. Didn't feel like the landlord was doing anything to remedy the situation, and said, I'm not going to pay rent on a place where you know, the roof has fallen in. And long story short, she gets evicted, and a young attorney at Legal Services, or who was at Legal Services of Eastern Missouri by the name of Lee Camp, gets her case, and that ultimately escalates up to the Missouri Supreme Court. And the core issue of this case is something called the implied warranty of habitability, which says that if you rent a place from somebody, the person you're renting from needs to make sure it's actually livable. And she had to – or it was common, it's common practice that people who bring these type of cases have to pay rent into a court in order to bring a challenge on this basis. And this case was challenging whether or not that's the right thing to do. And they issued a ruling July 3rd, so a little bit about a month and a half ago.
This is Missouri Supreme Court.
Yeah, Missouri Supreme Court. Yeah, sorry. And this is a bit of a follow-up on that particular ruling because it is just sort of a mixed bag, and we hear from both attorneys on either side of this case.
Well, part of the mixed bag is the fact that she lost her case before the Missouri Supreme Court.
She did, right. So, you know, the eviction stays on her record.
Nobody's going to rent to her if she's got that on the record, right?
Right, and not to mention the fact that she's in debt.
Yeah. Okay. What's the other part of the mixed bag?
Well, the other part of the mixed bag is that there was this practice of requiring people to pay rent into a court in order to bring a challenge on the basis of implied warranty of habitability is something that up until this ruling is essentially dicta. So meaning that it's a common practice, but it's not really the law. The high court in the state said that ultimately, this is not something that a court has to do, that it's an individual judge who can decide whether or not this is something she or he will require in a case. So this gives at least some avenue for people who want to bring these challenges and have legitimate challenges to not have to pay rent for a place that's not livable.
But that does not apply to her.
That does not apply to her.
Okay. What now?
Well, life has not been easy for her, you know, an eviction on her record and, you know, in debt, technically is homeless right now, is kind of, you know, continually looking for a place to stay.
She does have a job. I mean, she does have the wherewithal to pay rent if she could.
Right. But, you know, these issues tend to compound. Mm-hmm. There's sort of the legal part of this, and there's also the ethical and moral part of it, which is should your income or should poverty limit you from having equal access to justice?
I listened to the segment this morning,
mm-hmm.
and there is going to be another attempt, obviously,
right.
to try to get the Missouri Supreme Court to change its mind. That's got to be a tough thing to do.
It is very tough to do. So her attorney, Lee Camp, filed a motion asking the court to basically extend out this consideration whether or not she should have had to have paid rent into the court to bring her challenge to her individual case. But you know, even he will tell you it's a real legal long shot, but it's their last hope, really.
But nonetheless, out of all of this has come some good because the system
right.
might be revamped and revised a little bit.
Right. So this gives there's two sides to it. So on the housing advocate side, this gives them the ability to say to someone who they feel like has a very legitimate claim, like, hey, before you pay rent into this court, just so you know, you have the ability to request essentially another hearing to say I should or should not have to do this. Mm-hmm. On the other side of it, though, from the landlord's legal side, you know, they can basically try and steer cases towards judges they feel like are especially sympathetic to their side of this issue and will require that rent be paid into a court.
Well, once again, Tim Lloyd, you and Camille Stanley have done a great job on this story.
Thank you, Don.
It's just so sad to think of this poor woman, though, who was caught in this trap, as
right.
it were, and unable to really extricate herself from it. And to folks, as we always say at the end of these segments, if you're interested in listening to We Live Here, and we hope you are, you can download it from wherever you get your podcasts.
I like that. You sound good saying that.
You love that. Hey, yeah. I'm getting used to it.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Tim.
You bet.
That's it for us for today. Support for We Live Here comes from Metropolitan St. Louis's Sewer District. Archived versions of past St. Louis On the Air programs available for download or podcast at stlpublicradio.org/stlonair. St. Louis On the Air is produced by Alex Hoyer and Evie Hemphill with production assistance from Aaron Dorr, Caitlin Lally, and Charlie McDonald. Executive producers Mary Edwards. St. Louis On the Air is a production of St. Louis Public Radio, 90.7 KWMU. Thank you for listening. I'm Don Marsh.
Support comes from the Missouri Forest Products Association, committed to conservation and careful management of the state's forests to make them more resilient and better habitats for wildlife. Choosewood.com.